So for the last couple of weeks, I've been working on a project in Studio 3 in Rack, and this CS80 was, you know, hiding in the corner. So it seemed like a shame not to kind of, you know, have a go on it and show you what the CS80 is all about. For those of you who don't know what the CS80 is, it's basically Yamaha's Big Mumma polyphonic synthesizer. It's known for being the sound of Blade Runner, Chariots of Fire, and even the Doctor Who theme. This thing is massive. It weighs about 100 kilograms, and it's got a fully weighted keyboard, as well as polyphonic aftertouch, which in the 70s was pretty unknown of, like this. So basically what you do is you push it down, the harder you push it, the different the note sounds, and then you could do them all separately. So that makes it a polyphonic aftertouch experience. The controls are pretty damn odd. It's got a few presets here, and then you click over and you can use the actual panel controls, which are not very, you know, kind of friendly for somebody who's used to playing with, you know, standard synthesizer definitions. There's loads of odd stuff going on. So this has got 8 voices, and in each voice it has 2 separate oscillators that actually go through their own high pass, low pass filter, add a kind of additive sine wave. Yeah, it's pretty odd. Like, this is completely different to most other synthesizers. You can kind of add ring modulation, there's an LFO, the octaves, and there's like a weird extra filter here. So the keyboard isn't the only way you can actually control the notes. When you play that, you can use this sort of pitch bend ribbon cable to make the notes slide up or make the notes slide down. The other really strange thing is there's these buttons: memory 1, memory 2, memory 3, and memory 4. Basically, when you hit these, you open this thing up and you've got your own presets that you actually dial in using a miniature version of the actual faders over here. So each of these faders on the actual CS80 are mirrored into these tiny ones that you can program your own little presets. It's kind of cute. So the CS80 came out before MIDI was introduced, but this one has got a MIDI upgrade. So I'm gonna try that out when I'm jamming and, you know, seeing what sounds I can get out of this. This thing is crazy, and it's very rare to be able to get to play on something like this, because these things can kind of fetch like £18,000 nowadays, which is quite ridiculous. So enough talking about this, let's kind of just see what it sounds like.